Hello everyone, it's my pleasure and honor to be part of TEDx MMCOE. Imagine that you're standing alone, listening to your favorite piece of music. Have you noticed what your body does? Your foot perhaps taps the floor, your hands move a little, and your head nods to the music. You're so immersed in the lyrics, melody, and rhythm of the music that you don't realize your body is moving. And before you know it, your movement has morphed into dance. Martha Graham, a most renowned performer and choreographer, described dance as the hidden language of the soul. DMT, or dance movement therapy, that I practice helps people explore this hidden language through which they recognize, acknowledge, and express their thoughts and feelings. Dancing was part of community life in many prehistoric societies and cultures across the world. Most dances were collective in nature. People danced together during religious ceremonies to celebrate important life events such as childbirth, puberty, marriage, or death, and to also celebrate the change of seasons, and even on social occasions to find their soulmates. In fact, shamans or medicine men use dancing as part of their healing rituals with ordinary people. These were spontaneous dances unfettered by a dance form or a style, sort of trance dances bordering on natural movements that were produced to unify the body, the mind, and the spirit. Shamans believed that evil spirits were released from the souls of people who danced. These were the beginnings of dance as a therapeutic art in many indigenous tribes of the world, especially across Australasia, Africa, and South America, etc. It was only in the 1940s that dance as therapy became a formal discipline in USA and came to be known as dance movement therapy. This therapeutic modality was pioneered by Marian Chase, who was a dancer and choreographer herself. DMT was initially used as a form of treatment for soldiers returning from the Second World War, but later its scope and application widened to address people with mental challenges, physical impairments, and emotional disorders. And now DMT has spread across many countries and is being used in regular and special schools, in hospitals, in orphanages, retirement homes, rehabilitation centers, prisons, and de-addiction centers. In the late 1980s, I was invited by Dr. Grace Valentine, an American dance therapist, to study DMT at the Hancock Center in Madison, Wisconsin. I set off to the US on a scholarship program and returned back to pioneer the discipline in India in 1990. I used my DMT training to work with different populations, such as hearing impaired children, visually impaired adults, children with autism, Down syndrome, and adults with schizophrenia. I also received the Ashoka Fellowship to spread awareness of DMT across India through workshops and to also research into the therapeutic potentials of Indian dance forms. Much later, in 2014, I co-founded CIMTAI, Creative Movement Therapy Association of India, which was set up to strengthen the ecosystem of DMT throughout the subcontinent. DMT also falls under the umbrella of creative arts therapies, which also includes drama, music, and visual art therapy. DMT re-establishes lost mobility in bodies and enhances physical reflexes and mental alertness in participants. In some cases, adults who cannot communicate through verbalization have been able to express themselves effectively through dance and movement. In other cases, children who have undergone emotional or physical trauma have expressed their memories or feelings through movement rather than through words. So, movement steps in when words are not enough to heal the body and the soul. I had worked with an adolescent boy, Ravi, with Down syndrome. In our initial DMT sessions, he found it really difficult to concentrate on any activity for more than a few seconds. He would run to the door, throw an object he found, or kick a chair, all in one breath. The only thing that caught his attention completely was when I played rhythmic music and moved to it. He would immediately join me to imitate my moves while synchronizing his movements to the rhythm of the music. DMT not only stabilized and centered him, he was able to coordinate different parts of his body to perform many movement tasks and also make eye contact with me. He also memorized body rhythms by clapping his hands, tapping his feet, and tapping his body with his palms. His attention span in sessions increased during rhythm-based activities, which had repetition, structure, pattern, and predictability. His parents shared with me that at home, he would put on music in his room and dance his soul out every day. Dancing increased his self-regulation. He became calmer and was less anxious while being with his friends in school. DMT is not only used with people with special needs, it's also meant for the neurotypical people who are mentally, physically, and emotionally alert, as well as healthy. For example, teachers and special educators undergoing DMT training have trouble memorizing and sequencing learned movements in a particular order. The rigidity in their body also obstructs a full range of motion, and they find it difficult to synchronize their movement with others in the group. The DMT sessions for them therefore combines creativity, stress release, emotional expression, and social skills. Each DMT session is loosely structured into different parts. The session begins with a verbal check-in between the therapist and the client, followed by a body preparatory warm-up. Then comes theme development, which is the core of the session, followed by verbal reflection and cool-down. A person who's trained and practices DMT is referred to as a dance movement therapist. Most therapists create a movement activities basket, which contains a wide spectrum of therapeutic objectives, such as building concentration, enhancing self-confidence, or improving fine motor skills. There are approximately 45 to 50 of these objectives. Under each, there are many, many prefabricated movement activities that can be used in sessions with different clients. On one hand, dance therapists in India extract certain movement ideas from classical, folk, social dances, or other physical traditions like yoga and martial arts. On the other hand, they also use a form called creative movement to encourage clients to unchain themselves from habitual movement patterns and create fresh movements to use it for self-expression. DMT can be facilitated with individual clients as well as in a group setting. As members of a group move and interact with each other, social relationships are built and developed, and gradually they verbally share their innermost feelings or thoughts in these sessions. The therapist also helps group members enhance their self-awareness, coping skills, and teamwork through varied movement activities. A dance therapist's job is certainly not as simple as putting on music and asking people to move the way they feel like. Many participants would freeze on hearing an instruction like that, at least in the initial sessions. Therefore, therapists plan their sessions with a lot of care and use movement experiences ranging from basic to more complex ones. For example, in a session with a group of women entrepreneurs, I asked them to express how they were feeling on that particular day, using different body statues like sad, happy, scared, surprised, or angry, etc. Each person came up with a variety of body statues that symbolized their personal feelings. These statues gradually became dance-like and they portrayed stronger emotions as they moved across space. These experiences were used as a takeoff point to verbally reflect on deeper issues that were troubling them, such as anxiety, depression, fear, or loneliness. They also used movement props like scarves and dupattas along with their body movements to further their expression. During verbal reflection, we discussed the source, the intensity, and frequency of these emotions in their lives. One participant, Geeta, shared that these emotion-based dance movements had stirred up something really profound in her soul. She and the others then rehearsed new movement behaviors to confront, amplify, and let go emotions in a safe space filled with trust and empathy. In my long-term work with groups and individuals, I take them through 5 stages of DMT spread over a few months to a year. The first stage is movement seeding, in which I encourage participants to discover and understand their own movement vocabulary and also feel comfortable moving their bodies in the way they want to. The second stage is movement exploration, through which I guide participants into experimenting and exploring movement in a variety of ways, taking pleasure in the very act of moving and gradually breaking away from their own physical limitations. The third stage consists of movement expression, in which participants progress into expressing themes and deeper emotions from their own lives or exploring certain aspects of their own personality through movement. The fourth stage is resolution, in which we collaboratively explore a variety of solutions to resolve certain problems of the clients. For example, maybe a lack of self-esteem or assertive skills. The last stage is integration, in which clients attempt to incorporate new learnings and insights from DMT sessions into their real lives and relationships. Even before these 5 stages are initiated, we as therapists observe and assess the movement behavior, needs, and issues of clients through something called movement assessment and evaluation. This gives us a better understanding of specific physical, mental, emotional problems in each individual. After the assessment, we set short-term and long-term goals, and these objectives or goals influence the themes and movement activities that are selected for the sessions. It's worth mentioning here that during the COVID-19 pandemic, most DMT sessions were adapted to the online medium and was referred to as tele-DMT. Though tele-DMT had been in existence for more than 2 decades, therapists had resisted using this medium unless it was to work with clients in another city, country, or continent. But during the COVID-19 crisis, the transition to the online space has become a necessity. Most therapists have realized that their DMT offerings are the need of the hour, especially for people who live on their own, students from schools and colleges, the elderly population, or children with special needs undergoing recurring lockdowns. In fact, I have a very fond memory of having facilitated an online DMT session for the MMCOE students and faculty. The movement sequences were based on stress and anxiety reduction, movement energizers, and building resilience. DMT is a melting pot in which movement principles from different dance forms and styles meld and flow together. I feel it is imperative for us therapists to become aware of the artistic and therapeutic qualities that are embedded in dance traditions in India and elsewhere. Therefore, dance movement therapists have been seriously engaging with Indian dance forms and ways in which they can be incorporated into their DMT sessions. For instance, therapists select and extract specific elements like hand gestures, eye, neck, and head movements, as well as facial expressions, body movements, or footwork from different classical dances. Similarly, props such as fabrics, sticks, cymbals from folk dances are used to improvise movement with clients. Folk songs, their melodies, lyrics, and rhythms have also been used as accompaniment for group dances. All these elements are mixed, matched, and modified to suit the needs of individuals in DMT sessions. Movement is inherent in all of us from the time we were born, or even before that, while we were still in our mother's womb. Dance and movement have penetrated the human soul for several generations before and still very relevant to all of us in contemporary times. Through DMT, people have become emotionally resilient, mentally alert, self-expressive, and physically fit to counter all the trials and tribulations that life has thrown at us. This is why we should all dance, express, and transform ourselves using the therapeutic power and magic of movement. Thank you very much.